Hello students, today we are going to study about the representation of elements. So just we are going through the brief idea of history behind usage of symbol. Before 1600 AD, alchemists tried to represent the substance that they used by different kinds of pictographic symbols, such as triangle for the earth, crescent for silver, etc. But this was discarded later on. So in the modern world, later Dalton used the same way of symbolizing the elements, such as circle for oxygen, circle with dot in its center for hydrogen, and it didn't work. So this was also later been discarded. And then finally, later Johns Jacob Berzelius introduced nomenclature of elements, which laid the basis of the UPAC system of chemical symbols and formula. So Johns Jacob Berzelius nomenclature had some rules that has to be followed. He used some rules, some ideas to nomenclature, in the nomenclature of the elements. Of the one first is the initial letter of the element written in capital should represent that particular element. As you can see, O for oxygen, H for hydrogen. So the next is, however, we all know that there are many elements which start with the same letter, as in the case of the carbon and calcium. So in that case, we use the second letter. So when the first element, when the first letter of more than one element is the same, the elements are denoted by two letters. The first letter is written in capital, while the second letter is written in small, such as in the case of the calcium, where C is written as capital and A is written as small letter. In some cases, the suggested symbol did not agree with the English name of the element, as they were based on the Latin names or other language, such as Na for sodium. Now you can see that it doesn't start with the N, but still we are using Na, because this sodium has derived its name from natrium. So we use that as our basis of nomenclature. Now you can find a small table given here, which gives the element symbol based on the Latin name. So here antimony, it's Sb, copper Cu, gold Au, iron Fe, lead Pb, mercury Hg, potassium K, silver Ag, sodium Na, tin Sn, and tungsten W. So you have to learn all these element which is given here with their symbol and Latin name as your home task. Now moving in here, you can see a very nice example been given, where C stands for copper, C stands for carbon, CO stands for cobalt. Now I have a very important thing to say here. If you write C and O both capital, then it represents a compound carbon monoxide. It represents a compound carbon monoxide. So keep in your mind, when you are symbolizing an element with two letter, first letter has to be capital and the second letter has to be small letter. Now so copper, you are writing Cu because it used the Latin name, calcium Ca, cadmium Cd, we are using the third letter because calcium and cadmium they have the same first and second letter. So we use the third letter. Chromium, it's Cr, and chlorine, it's Cl. So now, so what does symbol signifies? By this we can clearly say that it represents name of the element, as in this case the O represents the element oxygen. One atom of the element or one atom of the oxygen, it represents a definite mass of the element, that is 16 gram of oxygen, which is equal to gram molecular mass. So thus we can conclude that symbol is the short form that stands for the atom of a specific element, or the abbreviation used for the name of the element. So you have to learn all that 20 elements with their symbol, and the most commonly used symbol of the elements which are given in your book in page number 3. Please go through it thoroughly and